crush a bit, little bit, roll it up, take a hit, feeling lit, feeling right, 2 a.m., summer night, I don't care, hand on the wheel, driving drunk, I'm doing my thing, rolling the mid beside and out, living my life, getting out dreams, I'ma do just what I want, looking ahead, no turning back, people told me slow my roll, I'm screaming out, fuck that, I'm screaming out, fuck that, I'm screaming out, fuck that, fuck that, fuck that. Fuck that, fuck that. What's up, everybody? Smokestack Reviews. I'm Sean, aka Ringzilla. Ducky's behind the camera is going to be in this review as well. But first, I'm going to get into this whole review, and this is going to be a product review.
You got to tell them what time it is.
Okay, it is late.
it is 3 o'clock in the morning.
3 o'clock. Okay, so 3 o'clock review that I've been waiting to do for a long time. This review is going to be on the Goliath Vortex Bowl. Look how humongous that is, guys. Look at the bottom of that. You need 2 grommets, 2 humongous. I'll show you later.
But, mod
grommets.
Compare it to that.
Look at this.
That's a normal vortex bowl. That's a Goliath vortex bowl.
So yeah, guys, it's very big. It's almost about an inch taller than the normal vortex bowl, and I'd say about 3 inches and like 3 inches wider. It's crazy. Now, if you look inside the bowl, you see that there's rivets all inside that push the shisha up and away from the bottom. So it lets the juice settle. It is a lot flatter at the bottom instead of it being an indent. So the juice just sits and lays around. The spire is more to where the holes poke up. So it's not more straight, so the juices don't get in there as much. And it comes with these right here, which I thought those were weird. I'm not sure exactly if those are supposed to help, but I mean, obviously, they thought it'd help enough to add it in.
They're supposed to help the hold the tin.
I know exactly what they're supposed to do. It's just, I don't know. I just don't see how that's really going to help too much. It doesn't raise up. It actually goes down into the bowl, so I don't see the real reason for that. But this will be my very first time ever packing this, so you guys will see if I fail or if I succeed. I'm hoping I succeed. So, catch you guys here in a minute. We're going to pack some Hookah Hookah watermelon. Okay, guys, I'm back. And I'm about to start the packing process. This is totally going to be new for me. So we're going to be packing Hookah Hookah watermelon. A, because if you guys can see, if you guys don't know about Hookah Hookah tobacco, it's really stringy. Really stringy. And this is really juicy. So I wanted to pack something I deemed easy to pack for my first time ever doing this. So Hookah Hookah. It makes the cut. Alright, so let me get to the packing.
I believe I can smoke.
Now, about this bowl, it can hold up to 50 grams of shisha. That is a fuck ton of shisha.
How much are we gonna pack?
We're packing 50 grams. 50 grams of Hookah Hookah watermelon. Okay, so I got the amount I think I want in here. I think I might have too much, so this is fucking huge.
That's what she said.
As you can see, I'm trying to make it level with the spire to where it doesn't pass the spires on the side, because I, again, don't get the real reason for those being there, but fuck it, that's my approach on doing this bowl.
That's a lot of Hookah Hookah.
That it is. Now what I'm going to do is take the fork. I suggest using an oyster fork, because it's a Tanger's oyster fork. I'd suggest pushing away from the spire, so you get optimum airflow. You can repack around, but smart to push away from the spire so the holes have a clean draw.
Smell so, it from here.
If you can see, you can see all the holes around. Now what I'm going to do is fluff back up on the sides. Make sure taking the fork and scraping it up to where it is level with the spire, but with the spire on the sides, not in the middle. Take a look. I'm about to pat it down a little bit. So, this is a humongous bowl.
That is a bowl.
Super bowl. So, this is a vortex bowl on crack. I think it's evenly packed. There's only a few little stragglers that are above. Seems to be good even. To me. Seems to be even to me. As you can see, away from the spire, make sure it's fluffed up to about where these little spires are, not past them. They're past them. I'm pretty sure it's going to be wrong because it's going to be direct contact with the tinfoil. And if you know how to pack a bowl, you know that's not good. This thing, yeah, that's hot.
I just heard your skin sizzle. Holy shit.
That still has coal in it.
That was gnarly.
That was hella gnarly.
Okay.
Alright, so.
What is that?
So, yeah. This is a Cloud Lotus that is very, very much still have very much lit coal in there.
That was ridiculous.
I literally felt my skin almost burn completely off.
You were straight up a griddle cake right there, dude. Holy shit.
Now, what I would like to do with this is put this on this. But see, that's not going to work at all. See how much difference that is? This is to fit a normal ball. Not working.
Mm-mm.
Now, the Cloud Lotus is probably one of the best innovations. Okay, guys. Well, I'm back. I just put the tinfoil on the ball.
Bam.
Bam. So much. I double tinfoiled it because I'm pretty sure it's going to need it. Because, supposedly this thing takes 5 coconars. That is insane.
Those over there.
Yeah, those over there. So, 5 of those things. And now I'm going to poke holes in this the way I believe they should be poked. I'm going to be using a Fumari poker. Amazing poker. So, yeah, let's get to it. I'm pretty much just going to go in a circle pattern around. That's pretty much just going to be it, but I think I'm going to space them out to like this. I'll just do it.
Better than the tack.
Indeed. And then I think I'm going to go wider holes. So. Closer holes again. Wider holes. And now I'm trying to go closer holes if I can. I don't know where the spire is. It's so damn big. Okay. A few more on the outside. Pretty much just a total random hole pattern.
Did those rivets work pretty well keeping the tinfoil?
Yeah, the rivets are right here. right here. I can feel them and I can see them right here and right here. So they are holding the tinfoil up, actually, which that's surprising. I'm thinking the reason why they did that is because you're going to be putting a lot of weight and coal on this. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 Copenhards. Now I'm about to use... Where is another... Oh, it's over there. Funny. Oh, never mind. Right here. Okay. I'm using two of these. One has been extensively used, and the other one hasn't been extensively used. So what we do with this... Put this damn bowl down without it falling. Yeah, I'll just let you hold on to that. What you do with these is... pretty much make Mod Grommet babies. And
make a super grommet.
Make a super grommet. You push these together to where they're like that.
Reunited and it feels and so good.
And then you take this monster.
Holy thing, shit.
And it totally just goes away. Like, you're not going to be able to see it when you put it down in here. But I'm pretty sure that'll work.
Careful, you don't want the juice to go all over you.
Yeah, no. Just want to make sure the...
Okay. Bam!
Yeah, that totally worked.
Maybe we should put it on the stem first.
Yeah, let's try that.
Don't mind the random array of cloud lotus and coconars.
It's weird. I think it's got some juice on it. We'll be right back. I'm going to go make sure all this is... done up properly so we don't mess up this one humongous bowl. Alright, be right back. Alright, so I figured out how to make it work on here. This is what it looks like, guys. Humongous. It looks humongous on this damn cam. I mean, it looks beautiful on it too, though. I mean, it is a nice bowl. I haven't messed with tinfoil here in a good minute because I've been using the Cloud Lotus and not this monster-ass bowl. But I can't wait to try this out. I love Sahara Smoke and I love their innovation in bowl. And I love the Vortex bowl, pretty much. That's the only bowl we use, really. We go from here and there to Alien Mini Funnel and Egyptian Clay. And I'm just happy to have this. It just looks nice. Now, if you pan down, we have 5 coconars going. Don't mind all this random shit down here. Yeah, but we have 5 coconars going, so we'll show you.
Tell them the box, be safe.
How this looks. Huh?
Tell them the box.
Coconars?
Yeah.
Okay, well. Coconara. You can use pretty much any coal, but if you're going to use like Exotica bricks, I'd refrain from using 5 of those because they're bigger.
Maybe four.
I'm saying 4 because 3 is a little too less. So a full brick and one other piece of a brick. So yeah, guys, this looks beautiful.
Are you excited?
I'm very excited.
Okay. All right,
so we'll be back. All right, guys, well, we're back. Now this is what the coal looks like on top. That is a lot of fucking coconuts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 coconuts. Now we're gonna show you how this smokes. All right, well, we're back. Chase is actually in this one.
So. Hello.
All right, so now we're gonna get to the smoke. See how this thing works.
Mr. Lotus. Personally, I think I get a lot bigger clouds with the Lotus. That's just me
saying what I feel, but I'm thoroughly impressed.
Okay. As you can see, this bowl is actually producing pretty nice clouds.
It hasn't opened up yet.
The bowl hasn't really opened up yet, so I'm pretty sure the clouds will get better. But there is a slight... It just pulls me away from this bowl. The thing that pulls me away from this bowl would have to be this part right here. It is way, way, way too big. I mean, you have to use two mod grommets and a Maya grommet to make it work. And that is very lame. the amount of clouds this thing puts out, though, is good, but it does not come anywhere into comparison from a normal bowl with a Cloud Lotus on it. Cloud Lotus. This isn't a Cloud Lotus review, but I've been spoiled by the Lotus, so it's not upsetting. The bowl's not upsetting. It's a great bowl. If you don't have enough funds to pick up a Cloud Lotus, which if you don't know what a Cloud Lotus is, make sure this thing is not hot. This is what a Cloud Lotus is. It comes with this thingy. A little wing cover that goes on top of it. So this is a Cloud Lotus.
Watch that review.
So watch that review. This thing right here turns any bowl into a grade A bowl. This thing, on the other hand, though, is too big to put the Lotus on it. It is a... For me, it's pretty much a waste in coal to use this when you can use just three of these for one bowl on a Lotus. And I think there's pluses and minuses about this bowl. Plus, it'll last a long time. Minus, you have to coal rotate and heat manage with this bowl a lot. Because, you have five fucking coconuts on there.
Another thing I'll have to say is, it's a bitch to get this thing to where you can actually sit down and enjoy it.
Yeah. It
requires some work.
It's a drag to have to...
I mean, if you have a party, it's cool. I'd understand that. It makes sense. But, all things considered, fucking pack a normal Vortex bowl. Seriously.
Yeah.
I'm not going to doubt this bowl at all. I fucking love it. But at the same time, okay, straight to the point, hardcore honesty review time. Believe it or not, as much as I was excited for this bowl and everything considered with it and seeing how bad things can be, because right now it almost looks like the Leaning Tower of Pisa.
Yeah, because even the coal on top is actually bringing the bowl down to one side, and I've used two mod grommets. They're fucking huge. And one Maya grommet, that should have been enough. If I had another Maya grommet on hand, I probably would have put it on there. Probably make it a little bit more stable. But do you really want to go through all that hassle just to use one bowl that will last you about 2 to 3 hours?
But you know what? Honestly, I'm going to give the bowl a solid 3.
I'm going to give this bowl a 3 as well. I'm minusing one big factor from the
fucking lean.
The lean and the amount of grommet. Well, pretty much the factor is how wide this fucker is down here. Now, the whole look and everything about the bowl is amazing. I like the concept very much. I don't like how you have to use five fucking coconuts on it. So that's another minus in my book. I wish, personally, they would have came out with a grommet for this, specifically for this.
That'd be cool.
So that would have been a lot better than having to waste all time and effort trying to figure out how to make this fucker stay. So, other than that, the bowl looks nice. I'm pretty sure it would smoke well for what its purpose is. But other than a long-term smoke, I wouldn't suggest buying this.
I'm going to dock another point. considering there's a fucking extreme risk factor here. Okay. We're talking fucking 5 fully lit coal. Now, if anybody's ever dropped coal on yourself or furniture or what have you, shit gets real.
I have.
Okay.
It's not fun.
3 is bad enough. 5?
5.
Holy shit. Okay, that's why we got water on hand. And then honestly, the next point, Doc, is the amount of coal it takes, the amount of fucking time is wasted trying to get this thing together, and the restriction. All that tied to one point. Definitely, it's a solid 3. I'll say it's a solid piece. I like it. Am I going to use it all the time? Hell no. But you know what? Overall, I think Sahara Smoke did produce something that is new, different, very innovative. I'm not as impressed as I thought I would be. And that's kind of upsetting.
It is upsetting because we were looking forward to this bowl. A, because I have to pack a lot of fucking bowls when we smoke. And I was looking very forward to being able to pack a bowl of something I really like and sit down and enjoy it. And another thing I don't really like about this is if your bowl does end up getting harsh to where you can't smoke it and it starts charring really bad, you are wasting 50 grams of something you could have used in 2 separate bowls. It's not good.
I mean, overall, it's good, but I'm not going to try to shy anybody away. I mean, you're your own person. We are all human, and we make our own decisions in this world. I'll be honest. I regret buying this fucking thing.
Yeah, I second that motion. He bought it, and I regret the fact that he bought it because it was a equal part on both of our decisions to pick this piece up. Good thing about this piece, again, if you can't afford a Cloud Lotus, me personally, I'd still recommend using a normal Vortex bowl with 3 Coconars. But if you want to, I don't know, beef up your arsenal of hookah stuff, make your rig look a lot better, I'd suggest, I'm going to try later on, probably won't be in the description right off the bat, but we'll update it when we can, but I'm going to try Exoticas on this to see if it works better. But other than that, I really wish, it was like $15, right?
Yeah.
This $15 could have gone to something better.
But overall, I like the appearance, I like the way it looks, it looks impressive.
Yeah.
As a whole, no.
No.
No, not at all. And this is just me and him being completely and utterly honest.
Our reviews are to help you people get the biggest bang for your buck.
Yeah.
This, $15.
Go buy another shisha.
Go buy another shisha and buy yourself a better bowl. Alright, guys.
Hold on.
Yeah, okay, go ahead.
No disrespect to Sahara Smoke whatsoever. You guys are fucking amazing.
No, God, no.
But for the most part, I'm just going to say it. What the fuck?
Yeah.
Like, you know what I mean? Like, come on, dude. It's like the elephant in the room. Literally.
Honestly, to be truthfully honest, there's no need to have a bowl this big.
I mean, party, I can understand, but shit, you can manage that.
Even for a party, you're going to have to do, if you want this to go, the listed 4 hours for this bowl, you're going to have to light 5 more coconuts. So you're going to be using 10. Because these will go out within, we clocked in at about like, what, an hour and something?
Yeah.
So these are going to go out easily within an hour to hour and a half. So if you're wanting to get a long session, you're going to have to use 10 fucking coconuts. And honestly,
no,
I like coconut more than I like the bowl. I like the coal more. So mm-hmm. I would use that in, I don't know, three sessions of a Cloud Lotus. So what I'm trying to tell you guys is go get the Cloud Lotus. Watch that review. Go get the Cloud Lotus. Save your $15, work up to 50, go get that.
And if you feel like you still have this drive or need to go out and pick this up, more power to you.
Go ahead, we did. I mean,
we went out on a limb. Fuck it. Thug life.
I mean, if you're a reviewer, but I would suggest you go pick this up, actually, because it's a $15 item. I mean, it's a nice item to review. Maybe you guys can get a more in-depth love for this thing, but not from us. And this is what we get from it, and yeah. So that's.
And we're not bullshitting you.
No. So yeah, guys, this has been a Smokestack review. Checked. This has been a Hookah Pro video. Check that out. Link in the description. Follow us on Twitter, Facebook, all that fun stuff. Instagram, all that fun stuff. Yeah. Rate, comment, subscribe.
I'm Chase. That's Sean.
I'm Chase. I'm Sean. He's Chase.
Thank you.
Yeah. So please put it down in the description if you have this bowl, if you have a better way to make this fucker fit, because that'd make me bump this up to a 4. Maybe. But other than that, guys, yeah.
We'll see you.
Stay smoking.